international spy.
It's very bad.
I wonder who's behind it.
Now the whole world wants to know that, too.
Hey, you two, over there.
Yes, sir.
Move on. You can't stand here. Hey, can't you hear what I'm saying? You can stay. You stay, I'll arrest you.
Morning. The assassin was a 25-year-old Chinese male. He was shot instantly by police. Several police were also injured. Now the police are investigating his background. Now over to international news. The Pentagon accused Vietnam of using Soviet-supplied Agent Orange on guerrillas in Kampuchea. Meanwhile, the TASS news agency denounced the U.S. for equipping NATO with chemical weapons. Both Washington and Moscow strongly deny these allegations.
A key to this door.
I broke it open.
Why is that?
This morning I saw blood seeping out and there was a strong smell, so I broke it open and checked, but then I found nothing.
Here, take this. Hey, Carl, you've done very well. Keep this to yourself.
Oh, I know, Big Boss.
This man Wu knew a lot. He's been killed right under your nose. You left us a dead end. Our political branch worked hard on this case. Now you cops messed it up.
All right, we understand. Even popes and presidents get assassinated. So what's the big deal about this case? Do you remember the ammunition we found a few months ago? You light that up, it'd blow up the whole city. But we didn't make a fuss.
Huh. You both keep quiet. I'm in charge here. You want to make a fuss here? You can wait till I'm retired. This case is not simple. There must be a superpower behind it. You mustn't act so rashly. Otherwise, there'll be more problems. Hmm? My men killed Wu Lai Ho in front of the court. And you've taken care of that Cuban killer, too. How the Beds retaliate.
Those two guys,
Don't figure much. They're after your goods.
We'll get information from the Eagles tonight. Then we'll know what the Bears are up to.
I'm sure they'll think of something. Stop the Eagles from giving the goods to Kampuchea. They want to get us.
They use rubles. We use dollars. See what's better. I don't give a damn how much it costs. Hey, you'd better be careful when you're in action. Don't be like that crazy man doing the job in public. Well, then, he got himself killed.
He did it on purpose. He wanted to quit. I'm like him. We were in Vietnam. As ex-soldiers, we'd killed. We'd killed a lot. We killed in Vietnam. And now in Hong Kong.
You must get rid of that watchman call for me.
Leave him. He is just a watchman.
You shouldn't say that. You know that if he ever let this thing get out into the open, then both our heads would get chopped off.
But...
We mustn't overlook any possibilities. Surely you've killed civilians in Vietnam.
This is Hong Kong.
It's the same. This is a treacherous world. Little guys like the watchman always die first. You make it look like an accident. Now, if I can get you out of Saigon, I can get all of your family out as well. But first you must earn their fare.
Tonight.
I'm busy. Get Kenny to go.
What's happened?
Don't ask. I gotta go.
Movie star.
Come see me shooting when you're free.
That's good, I will. Come to my house.
No, I want to stay here.
What about later?
Kenny, what are you staring at? Girls as usual?
Come on.
Let's go dancing.
Later on.
didn't come here today. You want fun? Come with me.
Scared?
Of course I am. Never do that again. Crazy.
You're lucky. No work tonight. I've been working like a dog in the studio.
Yeah.
That director's a real bastard. Hey, your wife Fanny kept me dancing all night. You've got to call her.
Yeah. I'd have trouble if every girl I sleep with is my wife. Fanny's crazy. Ignore her.
Hey, do you know that crazy Moon we were with has become a killer? Now he's been killed. What's going to happen to his grandma? Oh, yeah. Didn't you guys used to be good buddies?
It's Andy.
Oh, Andy, come. Come in, come in.
Thanks.
Have some tea.
Thank you.
Not at all. Oh, yes, Andy. My grandson, Amun, why doesn't he come to see me?
Amun's very busy. He's been sent to Thailand. Here's some money. He told me to give it to you. And some mince buns that you like. Come, eat while it's hot.
Thanks a lot. Andy, since Amun went to Thailand, has he written to you?
Yes. Yes.
What did he say in the letter? Did you bring it?
I'll read it to you. Andy, how are you? I'm very well here. You must go and see Granny. Buy her mince buns. I'll come back soon. Tell my Granny I've quit gambling.
Andy, all these years in Vietnam, I only wanted the family to live happily with you and for you to have a career. But now you're going to Hong Kong alone. And I feel I let your mother down.
Take this to you.
Come on, Captain. Wait for us. We can't wait. Come on, move it.
I'll get you all to Hong Kong.
You mean the Eagles didn't tell you?
Huh. You can stop beating about the bush. Come on, out with it.
Yeah. I came here specially to warn you. I got news that the bears are after us now.
I'll handle them. Don't you worry.
Rubles are money, too. Those men are not simple. You'd better send more men to help me.
Ammunition during the Korean War and heroin during the riots? Refugees during Vietnam War? Money. I've made enough.
With money, there's never enough.
But how much more can we make out of Hong Kong? I want to get away from Hong Kong for a while. Huh? You have a man called Andy.
Uh-huh.
Tonight, you'll get a message from the Eagles. Then tell Andy to proceed. Get rid of the bears.
Master, breakfast ready.
Coming.
Oh, Master, the young lady just called to say she's working tonight. Won't be back for dinner.
Tang Ying, you shouldn't come here again. Call me if there's anything.
Viet Cong agents, Man Man Bill, rank lieutenant. Yun Si Hung, rank lieutenant colonel. Wu Kuyun Cap, rank colonel. Exterminate them.
Quickly.
Hotel. Calling head office.
Go ahead.
This is Vickie. I'm now on location. Over.
What's it like? You need any help from head office? Hey, how is everything? Over.
Not too good. The ladies woke up sulking. Over.
Sulking? Why? Over.
You idiot. You asked if she needed help. Means she can't cope.
You get up there. We'll stop the reporters.
All right.
Hey, hurry. Hey, can't go on. No, we don't know anything.
Come on. Come on.
We don't know. You got to ask CIA.
Have you got any information yet?
We just got here ourselves. We don't know anything.
You got to ask public relations.
Hey, give us the
Hold it, come on. Quiet, please.
Give us some information. Yeah. Anything you got. What's this about a heart attack?
About half an hour ago, a room boy here discovered a dead man in a room. So he called the police.
What was the cause of death?
Oh, we have to wait for an autopsy.
So this is connected with the recent killing?
We're investigating. That's all for now. Thank you.
Come on. Hold it.
Now make way. Let's go to the way. Come on, move.
At 3 p.m. this afternoon, the body of a man was discovered by a room boy on the sixth floor of the Fuji Hotel. The police are... Hey, our pen, come. Hey, Inspector. Are politics involved in this hotel murder? Inspector, you're from the political branch. Why have you come here? Who's the dead man? Hey, your briefcase open.
He's from the special branch.
Hmm. Let's go.
Hey, go on. What's happening? Yeah, they
Bye-bye. Hey, big case?
Oh, I'm dog tired. So many sudden cases.
What's new?
One murder after another. Makes me sick.
Brother, we've received your parcel. Mom's very happy. We all miss you.
Hello? Oh, hold on, please. Vickie, telephone. Oh. Thank you. Hello, Daddy? Dinner? I can't. I'm busy. Aren't you going to Thailand? When do you leave? Oh. All right. Bye-bye.
Hey, here's a film.
The government has introduced new economic policies. Most Chinese businesses have closed down. Father's changed dealing gold on the black market. Our house has been searched many times.
Why so late?
I'm busy.
Father's health is deteriorating. Mother's very worried. We want to join you in Hong Kong. But each passage costs 30 taels of gold. When will we see you again?
evening. Here's the evening news. A murder was discovered at 3 p.m. this afternoon. The victim was a Vietnamese male around 30 years old. He was found in his room at the Fuji Hotel, lying in a pool of blood. He was certified dead there. The case has been classified as homicide. This brings the number of murders to 3 so far this week. The police have set up a special unit on this case, including inspectors from the special branch. Now to international news. There's been more trouble in Iran. Fighting has broken out again.
Could you tell us about the gas?
A bad smell. I've never come across it.
What are the effects on the students?
Nausea, dizziness.
Mm-hmm. And on yourself?
I felt nauseous, too.
Uh-huh. How did this come about?
We were having a class. It happened all of a sudden.
Oh. Then do you know where this gas has come from?
Oh, I've no idea.
Uh-huh. How many students need hospitalization?
Everyone in primary 5.
Early this morning at about 9 a.m., the Lutheran Primary School was attacked by a mysterious gas. Students in class 5A were all overcome by nausea and complained of dizziness. All the students are now hospitalized. This is the third mysterious gas incident so far this month. The government hasn't located the source of the gas. This is Vickie Lee for ATV reporting at the scene. Why hasn't the government come up with any answers?
We're working very hard on it. The medical and health department believes that the cause isn't toxic gas. Our investigations reveal that the level of air pollution in the school area is acceptable to us.
You mean acceptable, or you mean tolerable?
Of course, acceptable. We believe this group sickness to be a psychological symptom. This means it became contagious among the students, so that's why so many students were sent to hospital.
Could it be caused by the pressure of too much schoolwork?
Hmm?
We've already passed the matter to the education department to investigate.
So the gas incident at Lutheran School yesterday was purely psychological?
Regarding that incident, our investigations show, as there is a garbage dump in a nearby street, and the rubbish was not collected there for over a week, the stench could have drifted to the school on the wind and so caused this incident to happen when it did.
Or could it be caused by the exhaust from nearby factories?
Is that possible?
Of course it's possible.
Well, this is possible, but we feel highly unlikely because our investigations show that the level of air pollution from the factories is tolerable.
But you just said earlier that it was acceptable.
I mean it's tolerable. Well, if there's no more questions now then, that's it, okay?
Yeah, just can I...
His name's Kim Tae-yong, an ex-Vietnamese soldier. He became a spy after the war, a hitman for the Bears.
What do you think?
Oh, we've got news that he's here in Hong Kong, and he's here specially to take care of that Eagles gang. We must pick him up.
Hey, take it easy. Let them fight among themselves. We'll turn a blind eye.
Eh, what?
Inspector Lau is right. This case is very sticky, so don't make any move, unless we're sure of it.
Thank you.
Oh, oh, shoot!
Fire! Fire! That's an order! Check the time. You got 1 minute.
Andy, what are you up to?
Shut up! Tell me. Kim Tae-young's here to kill me. You know about it. Don't lie to me! Crazy Moon is dead. You're the only one who knows about me.
The bear sent him.
Someone. Someone's betrayed me.
Andy, I know nothing about this, but I can find out.
30 seconds.
If I wanted you dead, I would do it myself. As you trust me, you'd be off your guard. Right? In any case, why would I want to sell you out? Huh? Don't worry. Leave this to me.
Hello, Royal Observatory. I'm ATV reporter Vickie Lee. Could you please give me yesterday's wind direction and speed? What's it? Oh, 0.6, right. Thank you. Huh. How's it?
Fine, we'll take a look.
Let's start.
Not a bad shot, huh?
Rubbish. Hey, stop, there. Look at that flag.
Yeah, so what?
Now, the school is here. The flag is blowing that way. I checked with the Royal Observatory. The wind yesterday was from the west. The smell of the garbage was blowing away from the school. Got it?
Oh, you're right.
But I explained to you clearly on the phone. The lab reports on the gas incidents are confidential. It's government data. I can't tell you anything.
Uncle Wu, for the good of the people, please show me.
Eh? I work for the government. What's good for the people isn't always good for the government. Although you're my niece, I still can't disclose this. I'll be jailed for it.
Uncle Wu, you're always good to me. Please do it for me.
There's no way. Don't waste my time. I haven't even eaten yet. Now, I'm gonna buy a lunchbox. Keep an eye on these files for me. Don't touch them, or I'll be in trouble.
I know.
I'll be back in 10 minutes.
Ah. Thank you.
Thank you.
sarin, a kind of highly toxic nerve chemical, deadly poisonous, capable of rapidly destroying the nervous system. Soman, also a toxic nerve chemical, deadly poisonous. Very similar to sarin, but of greater toxicity.
No import of these two chemicals in the past 2 years.
Before that?
Yes, yeah, several years back. They're the importers.
Can I copy the name?
Sure.
Here's the address of the importer.
Thank you. Now, look at the map and check the addresses. Any of these importers in this area could have caused the gas accident. We'll check them early tomorrow. Look at you. Stop smoking now.
You're right. So dirty.
Let's look here. Come on, stop eating.
Oh, no.
Hey. Hurry, let's go to that one.
Hey, miss. We've checked over 10 places. It's time to go home. This place is so clean, I'm sure it's all right.
Just don't let their looks deceive you.
A woman's sixth sense.
You're wrong. Not sixth sense. It's new sense.
I don't have your new sense. You go yourself, then. I need some rest now. Goodbye.
Who do you want, miss?
I want to see your manager.
Hey!
Hey, you!
Hey!
What's
come
going on?
On
here? Can't you see that this
Give
is private?
Give me back my camera.
What are you doing
come on,
in
let
here?
Go of me.
Take a picture.
Come on, let go.
Yes, come
let
with me.
Go.
Come.
What is this?
I'm a reporter from ATV.
Oh, it's you.
Uncle Tang?
Give her the camera.
Uncle, I have some questions.
All right. Hey, back to work. Oh. Oh, yes. How's your dad?
I've lived alone since I came back from the States. We've both been busy. I only see him once a month. But you always see him at the previews.
Oh, yeah. Actually, we were going to Thailand. But then I've been busy. He went. I think this time he'll stay there for some time. So you wanted to talk? Come to my office.
All right. Uncle Tang, has your factory ever imported these two chemicals?
No.
You sure you haven't?
This is a commercial secret. Since your dad and I are good friends, so I'll tell you the truth. No. Now then, these chemicals, what are they for?
I don't know. There was a gas accident at a school around here recently. The students were hospitalized, and lab reports showed they'd inhaled these chemicals.
Now, my factory is a film lab. We've no need for these chemicals.
In the past?
Never.
All right, I've got to go.
Right.
Thank you. Hello?
Hello, Pang? Listen, tomorrow morning get two empty chemical drums and make them look like the containers for the two chemicals.
Oh, miss. Do you know what time it is?
It's 2.
Thanks a lot.
You listen. Now, you have another 2 hours of sleep. Have everything ready by 7. Never imported these chemicals. And tell me, where do these photos come from? I checked with the trade department. Your factory has imported these chemicals before.
That's right. Now I remember. We did import them a long time ago, but not for our own use. They were for re-export.
Re-export? Where to?
My dear girl, you shouldn't ask so many questions. You think I'm manufacturing toxic gas? Which sends students to the hospital? Come with me.
Where to?
To the film studio. Have to keep an eye on those directors. Make sure they don't waste my money. Come. TV reporter, Miss Vickie Lee. You should know her. This is our explosive expert, Andy. The best we have.
Hi.
Hi.
Haven't we met before?
That's so? I see you on TV all the time.
Vicky, I'll show you around.
Okay.
I'll take you to see your favorite star. She's shooting over there.
Driver.
No cab at this hour. You want a lift? What is it? You don't know me?
Oh, sure I do.
Then hop on.
Thank you. I'll wait.
I wasn't passing. I came to pick you up. I want to find out how much you know about Tang Ying. See, I work for him. He asked me to check you out. Sit down.
So Tang Ying sent you to find out how much I know about him. So go on. Now don't try and play games with me. Why don't you ask? So you think you're smart.
So aggressive.
No wonder Tong Yin is so afraid of you. You've got him worried now.
What's he afraid I'll find out?
What are your hobbies?
Tong Yin doesn't pay you to ask those questions.
I do things in my own way. Tong Yin wants to know about you, not me. So I'm not hungry. The same with you. You want to know about Tong Yin, so you're hungry. Have more. Like it?
Not bad at all. So now will you tell me about Tong Ying then?
Don't worry. You don't have to sleep with me in return.
Huh.
What do you know about Tong Ying?
I know a lot.
You want to know more?
Of course.
It proves that you don't know anything at all.
You're smart. Thanks for dinner.
Hey! Hey, hey! You're so touchy. How can you be a reporter?
Huh.
Even though we just met. Can we be friends? No harm in that, right? Okay?
I hope not.
Hey, I'm going to the refugee camp tomorrow. I think you'd like to come too. Huh?
My parents were divorced many years ago. My mother brought me up herself in the States. After studying journalism, I came back here to work. I hardly know my father. When I was in school, I saw many anti-Vietnam War demonstrations. You miss your country?
Yeah. To me, Vietnam, it's like a nightmare. For me, the war isn't over. Death, killings, muggings. I'm numbed by all this. My only dream is to get my family here to Hong Kong.
Christ.
Quit, it's too dangerous. But you don't listen, and the pay's bad.
Shh, shut up.
What's wrong with you? You're always like this when I talk to you these days.
Shit.
What's happened? You've changed a lot. You weren't like this before.
Hand me up that light there, will you? Yeah, yeah.
Why did you shut up?
I know, Andy. You must have found another girl.
Someone give me a hand with this.
Jesus, ain't you through yet?
Tell me what's up. I want to settle this right now.
Annie, leave off. Stop quarreling.
It's not your business. Now, if you don't explain things right now, then we're through. Tell me now. Come on.
You're asking for it.
Listen, your girl Fanny's being raped by my man.
Be there if you don't want to miss the show.
Are you crazy? Fanny was so good to you. How can you do this to her?
I got no choice.
Why don't you call the police?
I can't do that.
I can't, you.
Forget it!
But why?
If I do, I'll be dead.
Rubbish! Oh.
Listen. I swear I will cut the murderer to pieces.
Hey, Kim, do you think Andy will come?
Thank you.
Andy's friend, Kenny. Well now, I don't know how to tell you. Andy's just received news from Vietnam that his father, mother, sister
were all killed while trying to get out of the country.
And he seems to have gone crazy about it. He won't eat or sleep. Can you come and see him?
Right, I'll come now.
My life for money, hoping to get my family here. These last years, so many people have lost their families. And nobody cares about it. There are thousands of them. They're all Chinese. You understand? You understand? Let me tell you. Tong Ying's factory is manufacturing toxic gas. The same gas used in the Korean-Vietnam Wars, known as TX-24. He's making it for the Eagles, for use in Kampuchea against the Bears. Agent Orange.
You got any proof?
To Tonyan's factory.
If we nail him, will you be involved?
It's all right. I only care for you.
Check every film if you like. So what now, my dear girl? So this is your exclusive story? Is that right?
You
You got anything to say? A false charge. Now you've embarrassed the news department. It's your fault. Why are you so stupid? How can you let her do this? From now on, you're responsible for her, got it? Back to work.
It's close. If I hadn't found out in time, the special branch should have got to us by now.
Well, what's the reason you asked me here?
My reporter, Vickie Lee. She knows too much. You know what to do.
I know what you mean. But I can't do it.
Look, this is an order, not a suggestion.
She's a well-known reporter. If she gets killed, there'll be a scandal. I've been through a lot to get out of Vietnam. I've lost my country, my family. I'm tired of killing. I can't do it anymore. I'm tired. I'm tired of it.
But this is business. You have to think of the whole organization. You can't refuse to do it. That damn bitch won't leave us alone. We must get rid of her.
But still, I don't want to do it.
Listen to me. You know that once a killer, always a killer. Think about it.
Why can't you?
Why do you want me to stop? This is toxic gas. It's serious. And you're from Vietnam. You should know much better.
But the whole world is like this. What can you do?
It's the principle. These lethal weapons, they shouldn't be in Hong Kong.
Now how much can you do?
I don't give a damn. I can't stop now. Hello? What? My father? How come? Where is it?
What is it? What's happened?
My father's dead. His body was found at Chung Bay.
What was your father's name?
Lee Hong Fat.
Cameras, the same time. Ready?
Right.
Hey, take this away.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Yeah. Stand by. Yeah.
Camera! Cut! Cut it! Hey, what's the matter? What's wrong? Why jump out so quick? The car wasn't even there. Now wait for the car to arrive, you understand?
Okay. Yeah, you ready? No, get in your position.
Stand by. Well, you ready? Okay.
Don't worry, he'll be fine. He suffered superficial burns. He's okay. Because of his military training, he managed to protect himself. He'll recover soon. Don't worry.
He's okay. He's okay.
How did this happen?
Someone trapped me.
I'll find out who did it.
How do you feel now?
What'd the doctor say?
He said that you'll recover soon. You'll be okay.
Hey, you two have a talk. I'm going. Get Andy out of here! Take him away, quick!
After you?
I've killed many people.
But that was in the war. It's different now.
For some, the war never ends.
Do you know Andy's on his feet again? Not a scratch on his face. You've the gall to ask me for money.
Hey, boss, I didn't know that.
Maybe the explosives were damp in the studio after so long. Although he's alive, he was hurt quite badly. Remember, boss, I put my life on the line. If somebody finds out, we're both in trouble. I'm broke now. Please help me, boss. Okay?
Right. Okay. The last time. Eh?
Tea.
Thanks.
After you've fully recovered, I'll take my vacation. And we'll leave here and go somewhere. Mountain climbing, swimming, skiing. I'll cook you my best meal.
Vicky, I'm going out for a while.
You'll be all right?
Don't worry. I'll be fine. It's been a while. How have you been?
Resting.
Better now. So now, why do you want me to come here?
It's regarding Vicky. Can you leave her alone?
So you've been with her all this time?
That's right.
Huh. Why didn't you kill her? Eh? To a man like you, killing is a cinch. So why?
But not killing someone that I like.
Good, she's here.
Tong Ying! What do you want?
You stay away.
Even if you shoot, I'll kill you just the same. You try me.
Andy, don't let a woman come between us. It's no use. Sooner or later, she'll find out you killed her father.
Is what he says true? Is it true? Tell me! Tell me! Is it you?
Yes. But I didn't know that he was your father.
I don't believe it. How could you?
Vicky!
You asked for this. You think you're gonna get me? I'll let you join your father.
yourself.
You know too much about me.
Money is your grandson's. He asked Andy to deliver it.
Thanks a lot. Oh, yes. My grandson, when's he coming back?
I don't know.
Oh, where's Andy? Why doesn't he come?
He won't come anymore.